Hello everyone, welcome to Topper IAS. So as a part of our daily discussion, today also we will be taking one topic and we will discuss keeping in mind a mains. Okay, so let's get started then. So like what we have picked up today is with respect to cooperative federalism. So cooperative federalism, why did we pick? Because you often come across in newspaper with the term cooperative federalism. What we need is a spirit of cooperative federalism whenever an issue crops up between between states or between center and states. See, for example, you have seen like, you know, Constitutional Amendment Act, several states have been opposing this, and nowadays even the several states are demanding for GST compensation. So these are all things which require, you know, cooperation between the center and states. So what is the often said statement is we need a spirit of cooperative federalism. So what is this cooperative federalism? Actually, the term cooperative federalism was used by the, was referred by Granville Austin. So what is this is in the sense a spirit of cooperation should guide the relation between center and state on one hand, and also among the states, between the states, and states and the Panchayat Raj institution and urban local bodies. There has to be spirit of cooperation rather than, you know, conflict. So is what the meaning of cooperative federalism. Okay, so some basic points you should know. Basic things like federalism, like derived from the word fides, agreement or meaning is agreement or treaty. So federation is a new state formed through a treaty or an agreement between the various units. But what you should know is Indian state is not a Indian federation is not a result of agreement between the states, and you also know that federation term has nowhere been used in the Indian constitution. Rather, what article 1 what it says is India is a union of states rather than a federation. So these basic things you should know. And obviously a political organization, a philosophy of federalism is based on principles like centralization, non-centralization, power sharing, and these things define the a relation between a federal government and a regional government. Okay, so federalism we are talking about. So cooperative federalism, Granville Austin, there has to be cooperation between the center and states, that is union and states, and the spirit cooperation ensures that no one is, you know, one is right above the other. Rather, you should treat horizontally, equally. That should be the spirit. Okay, so not treating one is above the other, that should be the spirit. Okay, so to ensure this cooperation between the states and the centers, you know, constitution has already incorporated instruments, okay, which is necessary for, you know, proper growth of the country. So we will see some of the few provisions within the constitutions which aims to ensure a cooperation between center and the state. Okay, so one is, first of all, a seventh schedule. So seventh schedule, you all know, it divides subjects into central list, state list, and concurrent list. So this demarcation helps, you know, cooperation between the center and state, because you all know concurrent list subject, like for example, take for example any environment related laws, environmental related regulations, for example coastal regulation zones, all these things. So national coastal zonal authority will be overviewing, but states are the one who has to implement. So to achieve that particular outcome, there has to be cooperation between center and states. This is just one example. So there will be n number of examples. So to achieve the outcome, you need a cooperation between center and states. Okay, so that's, you see, in concurrent list subject, be it wildlife protection, national parks, and all those things. Okay, and the residual power has been kept at the center. So new areas, whenever the subject is not mentioned, so power is kept with the center. This, you know, avoids the conflict between center and state, because it is constitution itself is mentioning that residuaries power is with the center. Okay, and also one more area of cooperation is like article 249, where, you know, parliament to make the laws on subjects which are under state jurisdiction if the resolution passes in a state council with a two-third majority. So this is also an example for cooperation between center and state. Okay, and then we have other examples of cooperative federalism, which shows a spirit of cooperation is integrated judicial system, which established that established to enforce the both states and central laws. So this is also an example. And then we have All India Services. That is also a uniting factor in cooperative federalism, which is enshrined in Article 332 of the Indian Constitution. And another example is Interstate Council under Article 263 of the Constitution, which has been established to discuss and investigate the subject of common interest between the center and the states. So these are the things these are the few examples where, you know, cooperative federalism is given priority. And other thing is with respect to full faith and credit clause. So what are all the public acts, records, and judicial proceedings of the union and other state has to be respected throughout the India. So there has to be full faith and credit shall be given to the public acts and records throughout the India. This is a step to promote cooperation and faith between the center and the states. So there is a faith to the public acts and records. And then we have Zonal Council. So Zonal Council, these are statutory bodies established under State Reorganization Act of 1956 to ensure coordination. So according to this, it provided for 5 zonal councils and one for each north, south, east, and west, and central. And Northeastern Council is also there, but it has been established separately under Northeastern Zonal Council Act separately. Okay, remember that. So this is also meant to promote coordination between different states according to the zones. Okay, and then we have Niti Aayog, National Institution for Transforming India, government's policy think tank, which has replaced Planning Commission. So the main emphasis of Niti Aayog is also to, you know, affect our center-state relationship to bring about the improvement in the center and state relationship, as well as provide one of the function is it provides relevant strategic technical advice to both center and the state levels. So Niti Aayog is also one such platform which can bring states and center together. And one other recent example is GST. So, you know, Goods and Service Tax passed by 101 Amendment Act 2016, which came into effect in 2017. So the main whole concept of GST is one tax, one nation, so that there is a free movement of goods and services throughout the India, which will also give employment opportunities and consumers a wider choice and better prices. So this resulted in economic integration. So this economic integration was only possible and it was materialized only because of spirit of cooperation that was displayed between the center and states. So this is also an example for cooperative federalism, GST. Okay, then so these are the few of the things that we have seen. So there is a spirit of cooperative federalism within India, and there are a number of provisions within the constitutions. And apart from provisions in the constitutions, you also have examples like GST and all, which shows that a spirit of cooperative federalism has been followed in the India. But what needs to be is, so that's what this is an idea, not everything in ideal. So there are some issues, as I told you, with respect to CAA, Constitutional Amendment Act, where there is, you know, issue between center and various states, and you have a GST compensation issue. So some states are, you know, bargaining. So this is also an issue, and various river disputes between various states. So that is also affects the relationship between various states and even center and state river disputes. So there are, it's not like everything is fine. There are issues, but these issues can be resolved only if there is a cooperation between center and states and among the states. Okay. So that is the conclusion. What can we say is together we are more stronger. Okay. So federalism is a concept which needs to be adopted in practice and spirit rather than a letter. So just having a institution's laws is not enough. So we have provisions, letter than the people. That's the same thing. The statement says, no system is perfect, but it is the people who make the system perfect. So we have provisions, we have interstate council and all things. We have zonal councils and all, but rather than, there should be a spirit of cooperation rather than having a laws and institution. That will only make us to succeed as a federation. Okay. And institutional reforms, so as I said, interstate council has to be permanent. Those things can be done. And coalition governments accommodating regional parties in a coalition will also add federal will aid in federal functioning, because regional parties represent interest of regions. So once you accommodate the interest of the region, that will also ensure smooth cooperation between center and state parties. So that can be done. And one other is one recommendation is like state bill should be taken on priority list for the assent of the president, as the speedy procedure of this will foster more cooperation amongst state and center. And there should be proper enforceability of decisions in matter related to water disputes to avoid long lasting conflict among the states. So these are the some of the recommendations that can aid and help us in strengthening cooperative federalism in India. So we picked up this topic because this was in news, various articles during the COVID pandemic. Was there really cooperation even today? Now vaccine policy and vessel, all those things, is there really a cooperation between center and state? So the question is raised. So that's why we picked up this topic for today. Okay, so then that's it for today. Thanks for listening. You can also download a PDF of this document from Topper IS app. Okay, thanks for listening. Have a good day.